So shall we start with the homage to the Buddha, Dhamma, and Sangha? Okay, let's do that. There it is. Okay, so remember what we talked about yesterday, that this is an opportunity for joy in our hearts, not just merely reciting the words. We're going to acknowledge the Buddha as our teacher because of his superior qualities. And we go to refuge to the Buddha, to his teachings, and to the Sangha. And we recite the qualities that the Buddha, Dhamma, and Sangha have. So this is an opportunity for us to have joy in our heart and to deepen our faith and commitment to our spiritual practice.
Namo tassa bhagavato arahato samma sambuddhassa. Namo tassa bhagavato arahato samma sambuddhassa. Namo tassa bhagavato arahato samma sambuddhassa. Buddhaṃ saraṇaṃ gacchāmi, Dhammaṃ saraṇaṃ gacchāmi, Sanghaṃ saraṇaṃ gacchāmi, Dutiyampi Buddhaṃ saraṇaṃ gacchāmi, Dutiyampi Dhammaṃ saraṇaṃ gacchāmi, Dutiyampi Sanghaṃ saraṇaṃ gacchāmi, Tatiyampi Buddhaṃ saraṇaṃ gacchāmi, Tatiyampi Dhammaṃ saraṇaṃ gacchāmi, Tatiyampi Sanghaṃ saraṇaṃ gacchāmi. Itipiso bhagava araham sammā sambuddho vijja charana sampanno sugato lokavidu anuttaro purisa dhamma sarati satta deva manusanam buddho bhagavati. Svakato bhagavata dhammo sanditiko akaliko ehipasiko opanahiko pachatang veditabo vinyuhiti. Supatipanno bhagavato sāvaka saṅgho. Ujjupatipanno bhagavato sāvaka saṅgho. Nyāyapatipanno bhagavato sāvaka saṅgho. Samīcipatipanno bhagavato sāvaka saṅgho. Yadidhaṃ cattari purisa yugāni attha purisa pugala. Esa bhagavato sāvaka saṅgho. Ahuneyo pahuneyo dakineyo anjali karaniyo anutarang punyaketang lokasati. Very good.
So it feels nice sometimes doing a bit of a ceremony to start our practice, doesn't it? It feels like something comforting. Sometimes it feels like this brings a bit of joy into our mind. We're focusing on something that's important to us, something that's higher to us than our usual activities. So it feels nice. It feels good. And people really get into chanting sometimes. They love it. Do you like chanting? Yeah? It inspires the mind, doesn't it? It brings some joy into your practice. And so this is a skillful way that we can bring some happiness into our meditation practice. And now we're going to do some meditation. How long should we practice for today? 1 hour, says Lily. Oh, some people looking at Lily like, what? Any other suggestions? Or yeah. What about 50 minutes? 50? Okay, right? Good on you. So if 50 feels like an eternity, just remember, this is your time to practice. You practice in the way that you want to practice. If you need to get up and move and do some walking meditation or some standing meditation, then you can. If you want to do some walking meditation first and then some seated meditation, that's okay. So regardless of what everyone else is doing, you should look after yourself. Okay? Remember that. We looked at that thing yesterday, the log. So you look after yourself first before you look after others. You don't try to impress others with your spiritual practice. You do what you need to do. So let's do it. 50 minutes of meditation, of joy, of happiness. Remember that there's a simple joy and renunciation of just letting go, of not having to do anything. So this is called the joy of missing out. Jomo, the joy of missing out. Thank goodness we can just sit here, shut up. We don't have to talk to anyone. We don't have to look at anyone. We don't have to smile at anyone. Accept ourselves, smile at yourself. We don't have to look at our phone. We don't have to answer any emails. We don't have to be polite. We don't have to do anything. And if you don't want to meditate, you can just sit there and do nothing. So that's easy, right? And not doing is pleasurable. Sitting still, doing nothing, what a relief. At last, you can just rest and be calm and peaceful. So this is why we practice. So let's begin. And go through pretty much the same sequence each and every time you meditate, giving yourself some time to adjust, to settle, to arrive. Don't just reach out and try to grab the breath. Give some time for mindfulness to slowly develop in you. So we allow ourselves to let go of that world outside. We want to let go of that world and all the things in it. We give ourselves permission to let go so that we can be here, not out there, not thinking and pondering, planning and doing. Instead, we're here. So that we can be present. And so once we've decided that we want to be here, it's easy to let go of that world outside. It's easy to be here. And then because we want to be here, it's easy to become aware of what's going on in this moment around us. We're tuning in to the sounds, the light, the temperature, the sensations in our body, our posture. We tune into our mind. How are you feeling? What's going on? And however we're feeling in the body, we see if we can let go of tightness and tension to increase the feeling of relaxation. And this becomes easy to do. Just relax, let go of all that tension in the muscles. When the body is relaxed, it's so easy to stay and meditate. The body feels good. You want to stay. Whatever's going on in our mind, just like we relax the body, by letting go, we let go of whatever's being held on to in our mind. Habits, ideas about ourselves, the past, the future, problems, holding on is suffering. Letting go is freedom. So when thoughts come, we don't get involved, we don't hold on, we let go. So that we can have peace and quietness. So that we can be mindful of now. camera relaxed, my mindful. So it's easy for us to see the breath. Suddenly it's there, clear. We can see the breath coming in. We can see the breath going out. We watch the breath coming in, breath going out. We watch each and every breath. If we become distracted, it's okay. We let it go, those thoughts. We come back to the breath, gently. We see this breath is so soothing, so beautiful. It's easy to watch. And so this is how you can meditate for the next 45 minutes. Relaxing. Becoming calm. Watching the breath. And lastly, why don't you give yourself a little smile. You're meditating. How wonderful. So keep on enjoying your meditation for the remainder of the session.
Very, very good.
So for many of you, that was the longest you've ever meditated before, right? Sadhu, 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 well done. And everyone was so still and looked very peaceful. Is that how it was for you? Yeah? A little bit peaceful? Yeah, good. So you see, it becomes easier and easier to sit the more practice we do. And we start to identify more with the joy in our meditation. Less with the distractions and problems. And we start to feel good. And so we start to understand, oh, this is why people meditate. It's nice. And so this is a taste of joy, spiritual joy. So we're going to take a 10-minute break. And